हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, WE8412 टेक्निकल सेमिनार। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टेपर मोटर, इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ स्टेपर मोटर्स। कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ स्टेपर मोटर्स आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू ग्रुप्स, स्टैटिक्स एंड डायनामिक्स। स्टैटिक्स आर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू, टॉर्क एंगल कर्व एंड टॉर्क करंट कर्व। सो टॉर्क एंगल कर्व इज nothing but it is on a curve between the torque and the angle. So torque increases almost sinusoidally with an angle theta from its equilibrium position, sir. And there will be some holding, its maximum point is taken as an holding torque, that is denoted as an TH. It is in a dotted line, okay. So thus holding torque is a maximum load torque. This will be energized stepper can withstand without slipping from the equilibrium position, sir. So that is called torque angle curve. Next, detent torque. It is a maximum load torque which the unenergized stepper motor. Here the difference between two things is blue one is on a holding torque and this a detent torque is on a red one. And the holding torque will be at a maximum, but when compared to this detent torque. So it is a maximum load torque which the unenergized stepper motor can withstand slipping. So detent torque is due to the magnetism and is therefore available only in a permanent magnet and the hybrid stepper motor. So it is about 5 to 10% of holding torque. Next is torque current curve. A typical this is an between current and the torque. This graph is between a current and the torque. Here this this curve is initially linear, but after some time, but later its slope is progressively decreases as the magnetic circuits of the motor saturates. So next is the dynamic characteristics. So a stepper motor is said to be operated in synchronism. How we are saying synchronism means how much pulse, number of pulses we are applying, that much of steps the motor start to move. That is called as a synchronism. There will be two modes of operations, start-stop mode and slewing mode. That is, start-stop mode is called as a pull-in curve or a single stepping mode. So here there will be only in a single stepping, but in slewing modes, in start-stop mode, the stepper motor always operate in synchronism and the motor can be started and stopped without using synchronism. And next thing is, this is a start-stop mode. So this will be move like this way, but in a slewing mode it will be, its curve will be like this. And next thing is the curve between the torque and the stepping rate. That is, here the red line represents an outer and the blue line represents an inner. What is here? Pulling torque means it is a maximum torque the stepper motor can develop in a start-stop mode at given a stepping rate. And pull out, opposite to that pulling, pull outer is, it is also a maximum torque only, but here it will be developed in a slewing mode. So that one is pulling is developed in a start stop mode, pull out is developed in a slewing mode. So this is represented as a TP naught. Pulling torque is represented as a TP1. Next one is pull-in rate and pull-out rate. It's also difference is will the stepper motor will start or stop. It is a maximum stepping rate at which the stepper motor will start or stop without losing synchronisms. Here pull-out rate, it is maximum stepping rate at which the stepper motor will slew without losing synchronism against the given load torque T. So it is represented as an FP naught. Next is slewing range. Slewing range is a range of stepping rates at which the stepper motor can run in slewing mode, so with the losing synchronism at the given load torque. That's all about this characteristic of stepper motor. Thank you, students.